As the nation looks forward to being able to gather together with family and friends this summer, we are going to have celebrations starting the 4th of July and all summer long. I know that I'm going to be having some parties. So one way to create the perfect summer party is building a burger bar with beverage pairings to elevate the experience. Here to help is expert sommelier Theo Rutherford, who is also the training and brand education manager for Deutsch Family Wine and Spirits. Welcome, Theo.
Thanks for having me. How are you?
I'm great. I really do like my summer entertaining, so I am excited to hear about your pairings. Give us one entertaining tip that will wow our guests this summer.
So the big thing for me is, because this is really the first time that I'm going to get to see a lot of people, I didn't want to stand behind a bar or stand behind a counter or behind a grill all day. I wanted to be able to be out and mingle. So we decided to do a DIY burger bar. So that way you get the grilling done, you have all of your poultry or vegan or beef burgers that are out there, and then you have all of the great garnishes that you see in front of you. So you have some fresh garnishes, you've got some bacon, you kind of have anything you want. So that way your guests, A, you get to interact with your guests, and B, they get to have all the different flavors that they want, and they're not beholden to sort of, you know, do you want just lettuce, tomato, and onion? They can kind of go nuts with that. And it kind of impresses too.
Looks very impressive. Looks delicious. So what is a go-to flavor combination and beverage that you would suggest?
So for me, there are a couple different ones, but the one that I really like is I like bright, fresh flavors that are coming through, especially for summer. So I like doing something with a pineapple salsa. So fresh pineapple, a little bit of red onions, some jalapenos, some cilantro, a little bit of lime juice. It's kind of perfect on top of any burger. It brings some levity to that burger. Now, what you're going to want with that is you're going to want a wine that's going to do the same thing. So for me, I really like Yellowtail Sauvignon Blanc, especially the Pure Bright Sauvignon Blanc. And the reason I like it is it's also a little bit guilt-free because it's lighter in alcohol and lighter in calories, but still has that flavor and everything I want with a Sauvignon Blanc. So that way, a little later on, I can either throw some potato salad or macaroni salad, or if a certain piece of pie looks pretty good to me, I can indulge in that rather than worrying about the calories from the wine.
I like that lighter pairing. So for my traditional burger lovers who prefer those big flavors, what would you suggest for them?
So big flavors, you need a big wine. So for that, I really like doing the Josh Cabernet coming out of Lodi specifically for this one. So with Lodi, you're getting something that's a little bit bigger and bolder than you might be used to with your Napa Cabernets. So a little more stewed fruits, a little bit of smokiness that comes out. And so it's going to really bring out the char marks and what you've worked so hard on behind the grill preparing these things. And it stands up to things like blue cheese or caramelized onions. The other really good thing is we've had some really tough years recently with wildfires in California. So every bottle of this, $1 of all of the profits from this actually go to volunteer firefighter departments across the country to help combat those so that we can bring even more wine to you guys moving forward.
I like that. I actually grew up in Sonoma County. So those fires have hit close to home. So I really like hearing that. And I love that combination with the big, bold flavors. That would be my favorite, the blue cheese. So I do have vegan friends. What do you suggest for my vegan friends?
So for vegan friends, I like doing something like a really fresh chimichurri. And the reason I like that is twofold. One, it brings some really nice brightness to your burger, but also, especially if you're using fresh herbs from your garden, it just kind of adds a little bit of love and a little bit of personality for things that you've been working so hard on. It also gives me a really good excuse to bring out the gin. And so for this, I really like gray whale gin. It's 6 different botanicals that actually mimic the migratory pattern up the coast of California of the gray whale. So you're getting some really great freshness there with mint and fir. There's a little bit of kombu in there that adds a saltiness to it. And you can experiment with some great craft tonics. So you can do a Mediterranean tonic so it's nice and fresh. You can do an aromatic tonic so it's a little bit darker and brooding. And you can really have a lot of fun with that as well and impress your friends that you even know that these craft tonic waters exist.
Okay, you've got the perfect party plan for my friends and I. I've not tried that gin, so that definitely, and I do love chimichurri, so that sounds like a great combination. Okay, so I've got to go out and create this amazing burger bar. Any other suggestions you have to make it just elevated over the top?
I mean, the big thing is have fun with it. If there's something that looks great, that looks fresh in your farmer's market or in your grocery store, grab it and put it on that burger bar. Why not? The worst that's going to happen is you've got garnishes for the next day, you've got something to put in a frittata in the morning. Have fun with it. Pair it with a lot of different things. Try a lot of different combinations. It's a great conversation starter, since I know we're all a little awkward coming out of lockdown. We don't quite know how to interact with people sometimes anymore. So it's a really great conversation starter for that as well. And like I said, just have fun with it.
You know, Theo, I love these suggestions, especially when you gather people together and everybody has different dietary and different taste affinities. It just makes it so much easier for them to build their own burger. And like you said, as the host, you get to go ahead and enjoy the fun times as well. Well, Theo, where can we go for more information?
So for all the brands you see in front of you, your local retailer should carry these. So ask for these by name and they should be able to help you out and make your burger bar a success.
Sounds wonderful. Thank you so much. I need to go pick up a bottle of that Josh wine this weekend. It'll be a great addition to my celebration. Well, Theo, thank you for joining us. I wish you a wonderful summer and a great 4th of July as well.